so thankful for favor. Yeah, I'm so grateful for favor. Yeah, it takes one single visit from you and my life has been shifted. So thankful for favor.
Good evening, everyone, at Praise Chapel of Bible Oxnard. This is Pastor Johnny Montillo, and I'm so glad that you are joining us tonight for our Wednesday midweek service. I hope and I pray that tonight's message encourage you, inspire you, and draw you into deeper intimacy with the Lord Jesus Christ, and that you truly encounter the power and presence of the Holy Spirit through tonight's message. As always, I just wanted to thank our lead shepherd, the lead pastor of our church, Pastor Armando Carrillo, and his wife, Sister Veronica Carrillo, for all that they do for the body of Christ. Continue to keep them in your daily prayers always. I'm excited for tonight's message. So let's just open up in a word of prayer so we can dive right into the word of God. Father God, we thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, because your word is great, mighty, powerful, and wonderful, Father God. It refreshes us, Father God, when we need refreshing, Father God. It allows us to be revived when we need that revival, Lord Jesus Christ. Father God, I pray tonight that as we enter into your word, that we not take it for granted, but rather that we let it change and transform us. We let it draw us into deeper growth in you, and that we allow your word to change and transform us. Holy Spirit, we surrender tonight's service unto you, and we know, because you are in the midst of us right now, that great and awesome things are sure to occur as we go into the word of God. We ask these things in the mighty name of Jesus we pray, amen and amen. I'm excited for tonight's word. Tonight I wanted to talk about how we can be refreshed, because there will be times when we feel spiritually dry. There will be times when just life makes us feel as though things couldn't get hotter, things couldn't get worse, if you will. And we truly need those times of refreshing. When I first arrived here in the Middle East, the weather was almost about 120 degrees with 100% humidity. It was terrible. And the first thing I saw when I got off the plane was water, cold water, to get that refreshing. There's nothing like when you're feeling dry. There's nothing like when things are hot and in the area is hot, that when you have that first drink of cold water, that refreshes you. And that's what the Lord does for us when we feel spiritually dry. That's what the Lord does for us when we feel spiritually parched. That's what the Lord does for us when the situations of life make us feel as though we are dry. He revitalizes us, and he brings us that refreshing that we truly need. Because there will be times in our walk when we feel spiritually dry, when we feel spiritually parched, when the only thing that can restore us and the only thing that we need truly is that thing that the Lord can bring us, that refreshing. The word refresh, in accordance with scriptures as we're going into tonight, means to make room for, to take a breath, to be revived, to be invigorated, to bring about a cooling in scorching heat. And in these various definitions that I just gave, we can see that each of us truly need and can benefit from a spiritual refreshing, from a refreshing altogether. For when there is deep issues, we can feel as though we can't catch a breath. When there is spiritual lack, we truly need reviving. When there is spiritual lack, we need reinvigorating. And when we thirst to grow deeper and we feel parched, we need that cooling that refreshes us deeply. One of the most beautiful encounters of Christ occurs between Christ and the Samaritan woman at the well. That account tells us not only much about love and the omniscience, and that's the all-knowing power of Christ, but it also tells us the true need and the true source of spiritual refreshing. Our first verses come out of John chapter 4, verses 10 through 14. And this is Jesus as he's talking to the Samaritan woman. It says, Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water." "Sir," the woman said, "you have nothing to draw with and the well is deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, as did all his sons and his livestock?" And Jesus answered, this is amazing, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again, but whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of living water, welling up to eternal life." There, Jesus is telling this woman that he is the living water. He is the source of those things. He is that refreshing, even if you will, in times of need. that refreshing that the Lord brings will reveal to us that we need not go anywhere else, that he's the true source, and we don't have to go anywhere else for that refreshing. And it's a continuous refreshing, like he said. You will never thirst again. It's continuous, and it never ends. And as we dive into the Lord's word tonight, I pray that we get inspired to seek the Lord, to seek the living water, and to seek times of refreshing in and through him. Psalm chapter 63, verse 1 says this. And this is David speaking. He says, "You, God, are my God. Earnestly I seek you. I thirst for you. My whole being longs for you in a dry and parched land where there is no water." You see, our thirst and our refreshing only comes, our thirst can only be quenched, and that refreshing can only come through seeking the Lord. David wrote the psalm we just read while hiding from his enemies in the desert, in a most sun-scorched land, in a most desperate of situations. He was thirsty physically, parched spiritually, and no doubt was in need. When the heat was on, even if you will, for David, he knew that the only answer was to seek God, to replace his physical thirst and even his parched spiritual state with a thirst for God, because the Lord can only be the one who quenches and refreshes. When there was no refreshment for David, when there was no refreshing in sight, he didn't give up. He sought God even more deeply. For even when there is no water, even when there is no relief, he never gave up. And this is what is truly, truly beautiful. God did not abandon him. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 44, verse 3, we read, "For I will pour water on thirsty land and streams on dry ground. I will pour out my spirit on your offspring and my blessing on your descendants." See, the blessed thing is that the Lord will never abandon us in our thirst, in our need for refreshment, for spiritual refreshing, for refreshing physically even. That dry ground, that parched spiritual ground, is refreshed by the Holy Spirit himself. We just read that. And the most blessed thing, just like we read, is that the refreshing extends even to our entire families and our offspring. Perhaps you have been on dry spiritual land recently. Perhaps the issues that you are currently facing have you feeling scorched, even if you will. The answer is the living water. The answer and relief and refreshing resides in seeking the Lord and relying on the Holy Spirit. The Lord will pour out refreshing on us in our time of need. Yet also the Lord wants us to become sources of refreshing, spiritual refreshing to one another. In Romans chapter 15, verses 31 through 33, it says this. It says, "Pray that I may be kept from the unbelievers in Judea," and this is Paul speaking, "and that the contribution I take to Jerusalem may be favorably received by the Lord's people there, so that I may come to you with joy by God's will, and in your company be refreshed. The God of peace be with you all. Amen." You see, as a body of believers, we are called to encourage and to refresh one another. As Paul addressed the church in Rome, he asked for prayer, he asked for safety, he asked for favor, and he asked for peace. Yet he also sought the company of believers in order to be refreshed. As he noted, the unbelievers, if you will, in Judea had been threatening the ministry, threatening him. It was a difficult spot to be in, and no wonder he sought refreshment. And after being persecuted by unbelievers for so long and constantly being on the run, it's obvious that he may have felt spiritually drained, and he needed to be refreshed by the company of fellow believers. How many of you know that when you're going through a difficult time, if you find that brother or that sister who is able to encourage you through the word, who's able to refresh you through prayer, that's what you truly need when you've been going through a time where you've been spiritually dry or things have been truly difficult? Yet often believers who should be refreshing act as the unbelievers do and bring about more persecution to the others that need the refreshing, draining them, and more rather than being a refresher in times of need, believers can sometimes be the ones who are truly making other people feel spiritually dry. It's tragic and it's shameful, but us as believers, we need to realize that we can't be like those who sap the refreshing, but those who bring refreshing by God's word, by prayer, and by being there as a fellow believer. Point being, when we see a brother or sister who seems like they are in a dry place, a brother or sister who seems like they are in a spiritually parched land, it's our duty to assist them by refreshing them, like I said, in fellowship, refreshing them through the word, refreshing them by being an encouragement in their time of need. So we as believers need to ask ourselves the question, are we our brothers, are we as brothers and sisters in Christ? Are we there, are there for one another in our time of need? When even at times when deep ministry can leave people feeling drained, are we adding to the pain they may be going through? Are we there as being refreshing believers to one another? Are we adding to the pain that we may be going through, or others may be going through rather? We can refresh one another by the power of Christ. And beautifully, even in times where it seems no refreshing is near or no refreshing is possible, the Lord always comes through. Isaiah, again, chapter 58, verse 11 says this. It says, the Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land and will strengthen your frame. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail. I find that verse to be amazing because it states, in essence, even in places and situations where it seems no refreshing is available or no refreshing can occur, the Lord always comes through. This is a most beautiful and encouraging verse. In it, we see guidance, satisfaction, strength, and true refreshing, all those things that we truly need when we're going through difficult spots. Even in a sun-scorched land, even in parched places and situations that we go through, we can still remain in a state of satisfaction, a state of true contentment. Even though things grow hot and difficult, we can still remain and be strengthened. That's the Lord we serve. That's the Lord who loves us, that even when things are difficult, even when it seems like no way is possible, he still strengthens us and he still refreshes us, even in our sun-scorched situations. The most beautiful thing that I find in the scripture in Isaiah is that it declares that even in desert times, even in those times where refreshing may seem like it's far off, even in those times when it seems like it's truly impossible to reach that refreshing, we as believers will be like well-watered gardens, like endless springs, even in the difficult times. You see, the refreshing for believers, it's available. No matter how dry or how difficult the times our life may get, that spiritual refreshing is there and he guides us towards it. Even when it seems like life is trying to dry you up physically, mentally, emotionally, and most importantly, spiritually, you have to declare, I'm not dry. Rather, I'm refreshed. I'm a garden watered by the grace of the Lord. I'm an endless spring of blessing because of the goodness of the Lord. And that's amazing. That's amazing. Yes, we have a Lord who blesses us, even in the seasons that may seem dry, even in the scorched times, even if you will. Yet for the time of refreshing to truly take place, it's going to take some doing on our part. Acts chapter 3, verse 19. This is one of my favorite verses. And the verse reads, repent. Repent then and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out, that times of refreshing may come from the Lord. You see, our refreshment is directly attributed and proportional to the level of our repentance, our returning to the Lord, our having sins wiped out by the Lord. It's proportional to that. God desires that we get the full time of refreshing, that blessed season of refreshing's activation in full, not partially. And we wonder why that refreshing time hasn't taken place. Truth be told, if that time hasn't come, it may be due to our lack of repentance. It may be due to our lack of seeking the Lord. And it may be due to our lack of having a cleansing of sin by the Lord's power. If we want to be refreshed, we need to repent. We need to be repentant. Repentance is necessary for the refreshing to take place. Think of it like this. If we don't turn from looking at the dry ground and what caused that dry place, we will never turn to that refreshing through the living water, through the Lord Jesus Christ, and through the power of the Holy Spirit. I love how the verse we just read stated, turn to God. Often we turn from our sin repentantly, but we don't turn to God. Repentance without seeking God may change your behavior, but it won't change you spiritually. Truly, to have that change and that transformation, you have to turn from whatever has caused those dry places and turn to the Lord. to the Lord, and you'll be changed spiritually. For that true time of refreshing to happen, you have to repent and run to the living water. And when we repent of all that we have done, when we are truly repentant and turn to God, it cleanses us of our sin. It says it wipes them out. It wipes them out like a refreshing wash, even if you will. Because you can't enter into those times of refreshing with the old sin that you had prior. I don't know about you, but I'm done feeling dry. I'm done being in the sun-scorched land. And the truth be told, in the physical sense, I'm done being here, even in the desert at times, because it is truly, truly a sun-scorched place. I'm done feeling dry spiritually at times. I'm done not being refreshed, not feeling that refreshing. I'm seeking that time of refreshing. I'm hungering for that time of refreshing. I am truly, truly seeking that time of refreshing. Shouldn't we all be? Shouldn't we all be seeking that time of refreshing? Because we have the living water. And we know that even in lands that may seem difficult, even in seasons that may seem difficult, the Lord won't abandon us. And we know by the word we just read that we as believers, we could be refreshing one another and have that refreshing through the Lord's word and through fellowship. And we know that no matter how deep and difficult things are, that we're going to remain gardens that are well watered and springs that will never end, truly being refreshed upon refreshed upon refreshed in that true time of blessed refreshing. A final verse out of John chapter 7, verse 37 through 39, a final block of verses, if you will. It says, on the last and greatest day of the festival, Jesus stood and said in a loud voice, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as scripture has said, rivers of living water will flow from within them." By this he meant the Spirit, whom those who believed in him were later to receive. Upon that time, the Spirit had not been given, since Jesus had not yet been glorified. See, we find ourselves in a true place that where now Jesus has been glorified. And now we have the power, the presence of the Holy Spirit. I love how the verse we just read says, let anyone, and it said, Jesus said in a loud voice, let anyone who is thirsty come to him and drink. That's you and I. Let anyone who needs refreshing spiritually, let anyone who is battling a dry and parched season come to him and drink. Come to him and drink, and rivers of living water will flow from within them. The Holy Spirit will begin to flow through each and every one of us during that time of refreshing, during that season of refreshing. And I believe that's the time, the season that the Lord has us going into, that he truly wants us in this very time, a time of refreshing. A time where we feel the true power and presence of the Holy Spirit, because he is great and mighty. You and I can enter into that time. We can show repentance. We can turn to God. We can be cleansed, and we can enter into that time of refreshing. Are you ready? Because I know I am. Let us enter into that time of refreshing, and let us be refreshed. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, because your word is great and mighty and powerful. It inspires us this very night, Lord Jesus Christ, to hunger and seek for you, the living water. That even in our times of sun-scorched land seasons, even in our times of feeling dry, that you are there and you will never abandon us. And Lord Jesus Christ, we know that it's gonna take us repenting, turning to you and being cleansed. So I pray tonight that those who need that refreshing, that they follow that, that they repent, that they turn to you, and that they allow you to cleanse them, bringing true refreshing. And I pray for our body of Christ, Holy Spirit, right now, that you may bring us time of refreshing upon us, that you may bring a time and a season, and in the season, even if you will, where we will be like well-watered gardens by your power, always flowing with your power, Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord. And we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. In your most holy name, Jesus, amen and amen. And tonight's altar moment, I believe it's already been said, let us seek a time of refreshing. Perhaps you've been hungering for that time of refreshing. And now's the time to be repentant, to turn to God, and to be cleansed. I believe each and every one of us need that. And I know that as we enter into this time of refreshing, if we are repentant, if we turn to God, and if we allow things to occur, that we'll enter into a season that is most blessed, a season of endless water, endless presence of the living water. Let us enter into this time of refreshing. Let us go into this season where, rather than feeling dry, rather than feeling parched, we're refreshed, we're revitalized, we're revived, and we are following the Lord with everything that we have. Let us pray.
I found peace in the river. I found peace by the quiet streams. And I found peace on the mountain. I found peace in fields of green. And I found peace in the desert. I found peace in the raging waves. And I found peace in the valley. I found peace in what you said. Oh, and I can finally breathe again. Can't find.